for errands because Professor Krishnan has just spoken so much about her. Two of the chapters in Victoria Ehren's collection concern Latin America. One was contributed by Marlene Chinsky, titled Generation Without Grandparents, Witnesses and Companions to an Unfinished Search. Chinsky's piece reflects on Jewish Argentines, born before the war, who self-consciously or not witnessed their immigrant parents' frantic search for survivors among relatives left behind in Europe. Chinsky considers how poring over innumerable lists of survivors made available by Jewish organizations became a family ritual in which, in one case at least, a child took part, drawing on interviews, press articles, a novel, even a photograph that she superbly deconstructs. Chinsky ponders the degree to which the label third generation even applies to the South American environment. She writes poignantly that those who would fit into the category more often than not, here I quote, naturalized family loss, the fact that they never met their grandparents, uncles, aunts, and many other relatives murdered in the Shoah. We know such reactions to the Holocaust as relativism, forgetfulness, and its opposite, hypermnesia, the excess of memory, but we do well to follow Chinsky and consider naturalization as a response to the Shoah. The volume's other piece that involves Latin America was contributed by yours truly. I discuss the fluidity of generational classifications and, as does Chinsky, the possible forcing inherent in applying such labels. Hence my attempt to mitigate the expression by titling the piece, as I would say, the avatars of third generation Holocaust narrative in French and Spanish, the theme of conference of Latin Americans. I won't go into the French writers I examine, but following Elena, I study Sergio. It would be Hefitz in Polish, but who indeed, with a Polish spelling, who indeed may be considered both a second and a third generation writer. He wonders about the murdered grandparents he never met, as well as his father, whose existence before and during the Holocaust is an enigma poured over in Lenta Biografia. This is a text many of you know, along with those like other writers I study in this piece, Mauricio Rosenkopf and Manuela Figueret. My chapter shows immediately my indebtedness to the work at the Eisenberg, Florinda Goldberg, Vera Lockhart, and Amalia Aran. I go on to examine authors who I predict will be more present at Lockhart in the future, the Jewish Guatemalan American short story writer, Eduardo Alfon, the non-Jewish Cuban, Leonardo Padura, whose Herejes features a third-generation Miami Jewish artist as one of its main characters, and Javier Sinai, whom I see as a fourth-generation writer, since he reflects on how his great-grandfather, one of the first Yiddish journalists in Argentina, may have related to the Holocaust from afar. Indeed, this counting is very arbitrary and perhaps quite unnecessary. Finally, allow me to mention the upcoming multi-author volume, putting a plug in for the next book, that Manuela Chinsky and I have been editing on Yiddish in Latin America to be published by Brill in 2018 under the tutelage of Rana Rein, one of the co-presidents of Lachsa Brodsky. Among the contributors and several participants at this conference, Daryl Lockhart, Rosa Perlmutter, Kajo Lotterstein, Susana Skura, and Tamara Leeson-Reichberg from Texas. That's the book.